Hi friends, welcome back to my course Power System Planning. Today I am going to discuss electricity regulation. The electricity regulation means that the thing is to carry out these actions in accordance with the rules or conventions or by law. Regulation is the direct or indirect control by the government over the behavior of private or public enterprises in a particular sector. These are the main concerns for applying the electricity regulation to maintain the quality of service, prices to consumers, economic viability of the firms, environmental impact, policy for the services, market structure and power, investment as well its efficient operation to meet demand. The Indian government has made the laws time to time to govern the supply and demand. The first law, Indian Telegraphic Act 1885, which covers the privilege and power of government to place the telegraphic lines and poles. This also concerned with the penalties and certain other supplementary provision regarding electrical power lines. After that, Indian Electricity Act 1910. This is an act to aim at the law relating to the supply and use of electricity. It regulates license, work, supply and administration of rules. After that, the Electricity Regulatory Commission Act 1956. This act provides for the establishment of Central Electricity Regulatory Commission CRC and State Electricity Regulatory Commission SRC, rationalization of electricity tariff, transmission policy regarding subsidies, promotion of efficient and environmentally green policy and matters connected therewith or incident thereto. B. It is enacted by Parliament in the 49th year of the Republic of India. The Indian power sector is beset by the problems that impeded its capacity to respond to the rapidly growing demand for energy brought about by economic liberalization. Despite the state desire for reform and the initial measure that had been implemented, serious problems persist. As the problems of the power sector deepen, reform becomes increasingly difficult, underscoring the need to act decisively and without delay. It is essential that government exit implement significant reform by focusing on the fundamental issue facing the power sector, namely the lack of rational retail tariffs, the high level of cross subsidies, poor planning and operation, inadequate capacity, the neglect of the consumer, the limited involvement of private sector skills and resources, and the absence of an independent regulatory authority. Basically, this function ordinance have the two mainly silent features are, it provides the establishment of CRC, Central Electricity Regulatory Commission at the central level, and State Electricity Regulatory Commission at the state level. The main function of CRC are to regulate the tariff of generating companies owned or controlled by the central government. It also regulates interstate transmission, including tariff of the transmission utilities, to regulate interstate sale of power, to aid and advise the central government in the formulation of tariff policy. The main function of SERC to start with to determine the tariff for electricity wholesale, bulk, grid and retail, to determine the tariff payable for use of transmission facilities, to regulate power purchase, the procurement process of the transmission utilities. Subsequently, as and when each state government notify, other regulatory functions should also be assigned to SRC. It also made the state electricity board. It also aimed to improving the financial health of the state electricity board, which are losing heavily on the account of rational tariff and lack of budgetary support from the state government, as a result of which the SEV have become incapable of even proper maintenance, leave alone purposeful investment. Further, the lack of credit worthiness of SEVs have been determinant in attracting investment both from public and private sectors. The rule, after that, the Electricity Act 2003 came, which have the three segments: generation, transmission, distribution. The objective in the generation is de-licensing of generation, which attract more generators towards the generation. Liberalization in captive power, which increase the captive generation increase. Transmission, open access to transmission and distribution lines, by which the choice to choose customer efficient transfer of power. In the distribution, the objective are open access in phase manner, which impact is choice of buyer to choose supplier. Then stringent penalties for the theft, which reduction in lossage. Transparent subsidy management, equal benefit to all consumer. In all, overall, the regulation is a primarily designed to address the failure of market to deliver desired goods, whether economic, social or environmental. Regulation is the primary tool to address those market distortions and is when carefully designed, capable of serving a range of policy goals related to energy supply, including improved market, functioning, poverty reduction and sustainable development. There is no standard method that works in every situation. Therefore, the circumstances for different countries and the industries within those countries have to be analyzed and the most appropriate regulation method selected accordingly. This is the function of the electricity regulation. In the next class, we will discuss the forecasting. Thank you.